Hi, my name is Aaron Oliver. I'm 25 years old. I go to the University of Central Missouri, and I am majoring in dietetics. I will be getting my bachelor's degree at the end of this spring. I'm super excited. And although I chose dietetics as my career and profession, another huge passion of mine is music. The reason why I love music is because it's unlike any other art form there is, in my opinion. And the cool part about it is you can take any sound, like, or, and you can put them together and make a work of art. And to me, that's the coolest thing. And
click on and it'll make the sound.
And being able to take all those sounds, like, and notes, beats, and put them together and making this piece of art is really special to me. Well, I think my first exposure to music was when I was a child, going on trips to family reunions that were for whatever reason, like, hours away. But my parents would play like oldies 95, which was a radio station that played really old music from the 60s and 70s. And I was never really that much into it. I think I was more preoccupied with my Game Boy at the time. But I didn't really get into music until my later years, like when I became a teenager. And I discovered this band called Chevelle, which, I don't know, the first time I heard them, I was just in my head, I thought, whoa, this is so cool, it's so heavy, the guitars are so crunchy, I want to listen to more of this. And I remember, like, going to Best Buy and getting their album called Wonder What's Next and listening to it, and like from front to back, and just being in awe. Like, I thought it was the coolest thing ever. And they became my favorite band, my first favorite band, which was really neat. And they're actually one of the first bands I saw live. But it inspired me. I wanted to be able to do what the guitarist was doing in Chevelle. I wanted to be able to play like him and play that kind of style. And the only way I could do that is if I learned how to play guitar, and I didn't know how. So, you know, I begged my mom and dad to get me a guitar, and we went to Best Buy, and I got a Fender Stratocaster. No, not a Stratocaster, it was a Starcaster. It was like a knockoff version of the Stratocaster. It was really cheaply made, and it went out of tune all the time, but I thought it was so neat. It was red, it was pretty, it was cool. And then they got me guitar lessons at this local music shop called Legacy Music. And it was a struggle at first. I actually had to practice, but even if I didn't practice the lesson, I always played that guitar. I loved playing it. To this day, I play it often.
Whenever I work on music, I just start playing my instrument. I say, hey, you know what, it's, I feel like creating something today. So I grab my instrument, and I just start playing whatever comes to me.
I see music as kind of more like a hobby. Like, I don't think I'm ever gonna be going on tour with a band or anything, because I don't think that's for me. One of the reasons why I didn't choose it as my career. But I love playing music, I love listening to music, and I love writing music. It's just, it's a very spiritual experience for me. I love it. So it's always going to be part of my hobbies.
Everything I do, what?
And, yeah. Okay, so in terms of writing songs, I think everyone has their own way of writing songs, but I don't usually do it in the way that most people are taught to do it, because I was never taught how to write songs. Fair enough, right? So what I'll do is I'll just goof around on my guitar until I find something that I really like, and I'll say, hey, I could use that in a song. This sounds like something that I could hear in a song. And And then I use that main idea and branch off of it until, you know, and I come up with other ideas to add on to it until it seems like a finished product. Now, having said that, I don't think I've ever had the attention span to complete an entire song. Or if I have, I haven't done it. I haven't done it recently, so. But I can do it. I'm going to go ahead and do it today for this documentary. So I'm going to goof around for a little bit. I think that riff kind of sounds like something I could use for a main idea for a song, so I think I'll go ahead and go with that one. Yeah, so I guess I could use that as kind of like the main hook or kind of like an intro. I think I'm gonna go ahead and just start the song off that way, because why not? And then, so I'll probably whenever I have like a main idea that I want to start off a song with, I'll just play it over and over, and till I feel like, or till like my brain hears something that would sound great that would go with it. Go back to my main idea, the end of it. That sounds good. So I'm gonna play the full part. I'm gonna play the full thing. So in terms of recording, I've never actually gone through the entire process and recorded a full song. But what I like to do is whenever I'm just messing around with my guitar and I'll just come up with something. Like, if I decide that I really like that. I usually work on it until I perfect it, like. That's not good. Anyway, so whenever I decide to I really like something, then I'll break out my iPhone. And I have an app on there called Record That. It brings up all this stuff. These are like previous recordings. And then I click on the microphone and it brings up the recorder part. And you have save to, stop, play, and record. So I want to go ahead and try to record that part that I just came up with. I try to get it really close to the amp and far away from my guitar, because otherwise it picks up the sound of me plucking the strings. I don't want that in the recording. Decide to record, and I'm playing while I record. Sometimes I say, oh, I add a little bit of something at the end to make it sound like a finished idea, which is what I just did. So that's what I do whenever I record, and then I'll go back to it at some point and I'll say, oh, that was really cool, how did I play that? And I just go by the sound of what it sounds like, and I can usually figure it out because I'm the one who made it. Let's try that. Actually, I'm going to stop the record and save it as recording 567, just because. All right. And then we'll go back to one of my previous recordings and play that one. This one's called Majestic Flight. I named it that. That's the first part, right? That part's tricky. Yeah. Anyway, you get the idea. I haven't played that in a long time, and just by listening to it, I can be like, oh yeah, that's what it sounds like. I remember playing this at some point or another. It kind of comes back to me. And now I can add on to it if I wanted to. I could be like, and at the end it goes, what's it go? I could be like, something like that, or a chord progression to go on top. So that first note is like A. So I'd be like, you know, it would sound good if this was playing. This would go great over it. So that's kind of the way I use the writing process, or how I think of the writing process. It's really, you know, there's really no right way to do it. You know, once you get a cool idea, you write it down, you record it, you know, and then you can come back to it anytime and then add to it when you want to. If you want it too bad enough, you'll write a song, right? That's what I think. I got my laptop with FL Studios downloaded to it, or installed. So, although I haven't used it in a while, I have in the past used FL Studios, which is a digital audio work interface. Producer Edition. Exclusive with the yellow fruit. What kind of fruit is that? Looks like a pepper. How do I add stuff? We're gonna add a crash. We're gonna add a hat. I like this hat. We're using all the dance stuff because if I were to make beats, I would make dance beats. Should we have a ride? Plug in my USB mouse. I'm gonna try to do this stuff. Like every fourth. It plays on a loop. Here. Nah. I like that. This sounds kind of like a solid beat, right? You could use for a song and you add more to it later. Well, like I said, I've never really like made... I just like beats I can dance to. This is like the extent of how I know how to use it. Like just looping this pattern over. What do you usually do with the beats that you finish? I just listen to them. Yeah. Really, that's what I do. It's been a while since I've done this. You've recorded me talking about it, and then I've played ones I've done before. Right? Okay.
I mean, how does this help with your music writing process?
Well, I'm not sure to answer that. It's just kind of a way to be creative. And once I get better at this, I'll be able to make electronic music, which I enjoy listening to. I like rock music and I like electronic music, dance music. So I like a lot of stuff. I don't really like rap. Don't ask me about Kanye West. Or any of them, really. I think modern rap is kind of silly. I like that one. I'd like to have... Yeah, I like that one. And a lot of it's trial and error too. You're like, oh, I really like this. Cool. You just added more kick. The club kick. It's literally called club kick. This is club music. And then I would like, if I had a guitar over, maybe I'd like to play something over. Mm-hmm.
kind of come with a melody. I've never done that before, but I was like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if I used my guitar to come up with a melody? But yeah, kind of like the writing process for me. It's not really what you might expect from some other musicians, but like I said, I don't think there's any right way to write music. Just do what feels right to you. Yeah, that sounds good. You don't have to just come up with chord progression first or lyrics first or like beat first. You can do it out of sequence. It really doesn't matter. You just have to figure out how to add on to it. Like I could write like a vocal line first and then, oh, I want to play this guitar melody over it or this chord progression over it. Now generally when you're going to sing, you should already have the music done. At least that's my opinion. Like other people write the... You got like a really sick vocal line, you know, don't just throw it away. I mean, you can put it to a different key to match with this certain chord progression or, you know, but if you have this really awesome vocal, the guitarist, I guess, should come up with a pretty awesome, I mean, the guitarist should be able to work around that and make a chord progression for it. Anyway, yeah, that's basically what I think of writing songs. So, as I've mentioned before, I am a singer. And it's always, whether you're any kind of vocalist, whether you sing, whether you are a voice actor, or, you know, in theater, you should always warm up your voice. Even if you're a speaker, you should warm up your voice. And there's several different techniques to warm up your voice. For singers, usually try specific techniques that... the ones that I've learned are kind of silly. But they're really important because they warm up your voice so that you can sing better and easier and prevent damage to your vocal cords. And if you don't do that, over time... First of all, you're not going to sound as good, so it's kind of silly. And you're going to damage your voice, and it's not a good thing. So, what I do is a series of vocal exercises to warm my voice up so that I can sing easy.
So really what you
want to do is kind of make the brrr sound. I guess I'll go over
that. But do it like at the very top of your voice and go to the very bottom of your voice.
Are you ready for that?
So you'll be like... And what that does, it kind of gets your voice used to using your entire range how it should be used, with the correct air pressure and the correct, well, hopefully the correct support in your abdomen. And it's an easy way to do it. You don't have to think about it, just go. You did that as a kid, right? It was easy. So, and then you can also kind of do the same by bringing your shoulders up. don't really know what I want to play. I'm just thinking, where could I move on the fretboard that would sound good? Right after, you know, after playing this, where can I go that will sound good after that? So I could go like, I go like, I've been playing guitar on my new guitar that I got years ago. I guess it's not really new, but I always play my guitar, like every week. It seems like every day. It's something that I do. It's kind of like, it's good for the soul type thing. I like to play guitar because it's where I feel I belong. And music in general. I don't only play guitar. I've also recently taken up drum lessons over at the same store that I took guitar lessons, and I'm doing great on the drums. I'm learning Phantom of the Opera right now, and I'm loving it. Music is just really special to me. So, as you may notice, I have all these shirts. Like, this is just a dress shirt, and this is a V-neck shirt over here. And when I first set up my drum set, I had my guitar teacher cut. It's drum teacher. I had my drum teacher and he was all like, you should muffle the sound on your drums because duh, they're super loud. So whenever I play, I just try to play something that to me sounds cool. So I'll just be like, and it'll just kind of come to me as I'm playing. Like, I'll be like, okay. So I got this, and I got this, and this. So if I combine everything together, I could be like, and it's a trial and error type deal.
That's okay.
I'll try it one more time. Are you ready? Okay. We're going for the gold. Okay, now we're going for the gold.